even in our shift, can change everything. That, to me, really helped me view it from a larger perspective rather than just the immediate
quick fix. That was definitely a good idea. I also think, like, having about the actual hands-on clients, because we did have breakouts where we did have like, group discussions and working with and stuff, but having something, you know, tangible to physically work with and, like, change, I think that was really good for the group, too, just to see how we all work together and, you know, what different people can bring to the table. It was just much more hands-on and stuff. And, like, I would agree with you on my group discussions.
Yeah. And then you failed, and then you realized you failed.
I was thinking it might be just working on the scripts of other areas. It might be cool for an MDP program to work on a script just to understand the psychology and the reasoning behind things and why it's written the way that it's written, the importance of following the script.
But how would you recognize that if you don't actually use it?
Well, I think it's beneficial. I mean, from my perspective, I've been in advising, and I went through boot camp, so I wasn't in as a specialist for an extended time. But I think that it's just beneficial if you're understanding the business and you're understanding everything as a whole to understand that aspect.
I mean, definitely seeing and walking through the script helps, but I think, like, with the EMT team, when I have them, you know, writing the script, and then they get on the phone to work about it.
Right.
So then it's like they understand, okay, well, wow, this was tough, it was hard to do this, but you don't do that unless you actually take the pulse. You know, that's really the you know, without that element of it, it's like, it's like saying, I'm going to cook a meal, but I'm not going to taste it. You know, I'm going to go cook it, and here you go, and this is the meal. Well, if you don't taste it, you see, well, wait, you know, it's too spicy, or you're not going to make the adjustments to correct it. So it's hard to really have somebody do something that you can't go out and test and say, okay, here's, you know, how it would work, right? Because you look at the script and say, oh, sounds great, it should be perfect, and then you take it and you realize, okay, people aren't reacting the way you think they are.
What did you see as the end goal for this program the first time through?
My main purpose in this program was to, actually, there's probably two. The first one was, we were, and are at a point where we need leadership, and we had made some bad decisions, and the decisions were based on, people coming in, my interaction with people was very short. So I would meet with somebody and they'd sit in a meeting, maybe they're intimidated, maybe somebody said something that sounded really smart, and you'd be like, oh, that person's really good, and realize somebody else had just told them that before. Mm-hmm. It was the one really thought they ever had. So you would kind of promote that person and then realize, they didn't have problem-solving abilities. That once you tried to, there was no depth. So I wanted to really kind of get to know people in different environments and actually spend time with people and say, okay, I kind of know what I'm getting. You know? So from a standpoint of, as a senior executive in the company, that was important to me. You know, now it's not like I just know who your names are. I know